the matter with me? Think I'm stuck in a dream.
Hey, what's up, you guys, and welcome back to Gal. Now, today we're going to be talking about music, and music is such an important part of your editing process. At least for me, it's usually the first thing that I look for when I begin my edit, and it kind of, I don't know, it creates the tone and the mood for your film. It complements the imagery, right? So I've used Soundstripe for years, and Soundstripe is actually the sponsor of this video, and I'm super excited that they just came out with a new Premiere Pro panel where you can search their library directly in Premiere. And when you license it, it downloads directly into your project panel. Soundstripe is unlimited, so it's a monthly fee, so you can get as much music as you want for any type of project. There's no licensing issues. So thanks to Soundstripe for sponsoring this video. If you guys want to sign up for it and test it out, you can use my code GAL10. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you a little bit about how to use the panel and then how you can remix the music track to be any duration for any video. So you can take a track that's 3 minutes and remix it down to 1 minute and 30 seconds if that's the length of your video. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump on in. So to download the Soundstripe extension, you're gonna download it from the Adobe Exchange, and it's free. You just click free and then it will just install directly into your Adobe Creative Cloud desktop app. Of course, you can use Soundstripe without Premiere. You would just go to their web app and you can search here and download. So let's show you how it looks like inside of Premiere. So once it's installed, you're gonna go up to Window, Extensions, and open up Soundstripe. All right, so once you're inside the Soundstripe panel, this is where you can start to filter for your music. You can search by mood, genre, pace, instruments, key, artist, playlist, vocals or instrument, duration, BPM, and even advanced. Underneath advanced, because I'm always looking for new music, I always check hide previously licensed. That way I'm not getting the same music. So for this sequence that I have, if I open up the program, it's just the stock video shot of this guy on the mountain. So I'm looking for something that's kind of inspiring and cinematic. So this is where Soundstripe comes in handy. So I can choose mood and I can choose inspiring as a mood. And you can see that the filter is applied. Now for genre, let's choose cinematic, and then let's choose a pace that's kind of slow because the footage is in slow motion, so we'll try that. And then you can definitely search different playlists if you like, or particular artists that you're a fan of inside the Soundstripe library. But for us, I'm always open to finding new artists. So you can go through and start to listen to all these tracks that have these filters on until you find one that you like. So I found this track here, let's just play it back for you. So I really liked the sound and vibe of this particular track. Of course, if you're looking for a particular instrument, like a piano versus a guitar, this is where you can filter by the type of instrument, which comes in handy if you need to narrow down your search more. So what we can do now is we can then download and license this track. If you do not have a Soundstripe account, you can always import the watermark track until you're ready to sign up. And once you do sign up, be sure to use the code GAL10 to get 10% off. So you see, I'm logged in here. All I need to do is license the track, and then Soundstripe automatically puts in the project title, the same title as your Premiere Pro project title. But of course, you can edit this. Then you can choose the licensing type. So what type of project is this for? I chose tutorials because that's what my content is, but you can choose any type of project here. There's a vast array. What I really like is they have nonprofit, real estate, all sorts of different things, all the way down to YouTube creator and vlog, which is pretty cool. Then you just choose the type, MP3 or WAV. I'm gonna choose WAV, and it starts to license it and it will import it into your project panel. So you can see it's here. It was automatically put into my music folder because I had that folder selected while I did that. So you can double click and you can see that we have the full audio track here. Now it's a minute in duration roughly. And this sequence is 45 seconds in duration here. So what we need to do is remix this. So let's go ahead and double click that again and drag this into our sequence here. And you can see it's longer. We need to remix it. Now, one thing to bear in mind is that Soundstripe does have certain tracks that have these arrow down, so you can see if there's alternate versions that are in the duration of your video, which is useful. So you may be able to use this, but because this particular track doesn't have any other alternate versions, I need to remix it using Audition's features. So to do that, you're just going to select the clip, right click, and go into Edit Clip in Adobe Audition. And from here, you just need to make sure to create a multi-track session. So right click and create new multi-track session, and we'll just call this session and hit OK. And then you're going to drag and drop the audio clip in here. So now we have the audio track in here. And the next step is to choose the audio type. We're going to choose music, and then we're going to check duration. And this is where we can put 45 seconds, since that's the duration of our video, and then hit remix. And it will start to analyze this clip. You'll see the percentage, and bam, it's done. And you can see the resulting target. It got it down to 49 seconds. So what it did was create cuts automatically. So you can see it just made one cut here. Let me just make this bigger so you can see it's kind of like a Frankenstein cut. And it found that to automatically make a cut to match the beat. So that way it's almost seamless and you can't hear the difference. So let's listen back to see how well it did. I couldn't hear a cut there, so that was pretty seamless. So sometimes you'll get multiple cuts, and other times it's a very simple cut. So you can see it's a little bit longer than 45 seconds. So what we need to do is play around with a different time. Let's try 40. And it ends now at around 44 seconds, which is close enough to what we need. So you can see the only cut here was done here. Let's just make sure that we can't hear any cuts. It was perfect. So then what we need to do is we need to go to File, and we need to go to Export, Export to Premiere Pro, mix it down to a stereo file, and then be sure to open it up in Premiere and hit Export. And then you can choose which audio track to import it into. Let's choose audio track 3. So I'll just choose A3 and hit OK. And now what we can do is we can just delete this previous track. And now you can see it ends perfectly. We can just roll these clips back, and let's just play it back to see how it ends. I love the remix feature because you can really get that feeling of the music ending, like the music was actually composed for the video versus just adding a cross dissolve to the end of the audio track. This is why I love the remix feature. But again, remember, you can always use Soundstripe's alternate versions if you're looking for a particular length, so you don't have to use Remix, but use the Remix tool if you really need a customized length for your video. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys want more music or audio related content on the channel, be sure to give this video a thumbs up. And if it reaches 5,000 likes, I know that you guys want more content like this. Be sure to use my code GAL10 if you would like to sign up for a Soundstripe membership. I'll put my link to a playlist of music that I use in the description box below. And a huge shout out to my new patrons. We just hit over 50 patrons on my Patreon community. If you guys join, you can get free templates each month, unlimited access to my store, and direct message support. So cheers to everyone that has shown their support. Head over to patreon.com/premieregal and check it out. Thanks again. See you guys next time. Bye.
What's the matter with me?